The Cintiq 13 is a slim pen display that empowers creative people with an intuitive interface to their graphic applications. Aside from the power of the Pro Pen and its precision and heightened pressure sensitivity compared to its predecessor, the Cintiq 12, this Cintiq comes with a number of additional features that deserve brief introductions and overviews. The Cintiq 13 has a number of time-saving features, like the four express keys, that allow for quick access to certain Wacom functions and other common tasks. Between the express keys is a four-position rocker ring and home button, effectively five buttons in one, that can make your most commonly used functions easily accessible without having to move your thumb. The Cintiq 13 now has a convenient USB port on the side, next to the more streamlined 3-in-1 cable. Overall, this Cintiq is more versatile, slim, and compact than ever. It's also been updated to an HDMI connection. Even with its small size, the Cintiq 13 packs a full 1080p HD resolution, delivering 1920 by 1080 pixels. The other physical differences from its predecessor include a detachable four-position stand for working flat or at 22, 35, or 50 degrees. In addition to the desktop pen stand, there's a redesigned pen, and the Cintiq 13 also comes with a pen carrying case in which you'll find 9 extra nibs, a nib puller, and various color rings to distinguish your pen from others in the office. The important features that may need additional introductions are precision mode for detail work, display toggle to give people the freedom of working with multiple displays without having to put down their pen, and the customizable radial menu, where literally more than 2,000 of your favorite keyboard shortcuts could be set up to work with your core applications. These three Wacom-specific features can all be applied to any of the functions of the tablet, from the express keys, the rocker ring, or even the pin switches. Just open Wacom Tablet Properties from the Apple menu, System Preferences, or on a Windows system you'll find it in All Programs or Control Panels. However, the easiest way to get to the tablet properties is to press the topmost express key on your Cintiq to show its settings. Then just tap on whichever function you want to change, and it will bring up the tablet properties window on the appropriate tab. To start with, precision mode is of particular interest for the small Cintiq. Because of its high resolution in such a small space, small movements of the pen still cover a large number of pixels. However, by holding down an express key to set precision mode, it temporarily remaps the entire pen tablet area to a much smaller portion of the screen, giving you the ability to make pixel-level adjustments with larger pen movements. You can also quickly press and release the precision mode key to set precision mode. Using it this way makes it behave as an on-off toggle, rather than having to hold down the button during the duration of the precision mapping. To release it from precision mode, just press and release the button again. You can further refine the settings for precision mode in the Wacom tablet properties by selecting precision mode for whichever express key you have it assigned. This will open a dialog where you can adjust the size of the precision window to best fit your workflow. Display toggle is precision mode's remapping counterpart. Rather than reducing the movement of the pointer, display toggle lets you access other screens while keeping the pen on the Cintiq 13. This is particularly efficient when the Cintiq is set up as your primary display, and you want to get to panels or assets that have been moved to another monitor. Since the Cintiq 13 is almost always going to be in a multiple monitor configuration, you now have the ability to interact with your entire display area when you need to, but quickly get back to your creative work solely on the Cintiq. To use display toggle, press any express key set to display toggle, and your pen will map as if it were an Intuos tablet across all screens. Each corner of the Cintiq will now represent that corner of your overall display area until you press the display toggle button again. Like precision mode, you can change this behavior in the tablet properties by selecting functions in the tools list and selecting the display toggle tab. On the display toggle tab, you can adjust how the display toggle function interacts with your displays. The default behavior is pen displays to desktop, which means across all active displays as you travel from corner to corner with the pen on the Cintiq. Pen display to other displays will temporarily map the Cintiq surface to the area of another active display. With this setting, if you have more than two displays, it will toggle between each of them, then back to the Cintiq. The last of these three powerful Wacom features is the radial menu. If the 11 customizable keys, ring, and switch functions were not enough to occasionally free you from the keyboard, once set up, the radial menu theoretically could. The radial menu is a customizable 8-slice interactive pie that you can call up by pressing any button you have assigned to radial menu. You then just tap whichever slice is set to the function you are looking for. The default menus are fairly generic and designed for a broad number of applications. To build one specific to your favorite program, first open the program in question, go back to the tablet properties, and click the plus to the right of the applications list. Then select the application for which you want to create a custom radial menu, and click OK. Each slice of the pie can now be configured to perform a wealth of functions for that specific application. The most common use of a slice will be to send a keystroke to the system instead of having to use a keyboard shortcut. To do this, select the slice you want to change, select Keystroke from the drop-down dialog, and define the keystroke. To record the keystroke, make sure the cursor is blinking in the keys field. If it's not, just click in the field, then perform the keyboard shortcut exactly as if you were in the application you wanted to use. This could be anything from an application-specific keyboard shortcut to an action you've created and assigned a shortcut key. The next most common setting is the one that really opens the power of the radial menu, the submenu. By choosing submenu, you create another layer of 8 slices under the initially selected slice. Name the submenu appropriately, either based on your workflow or, for instance, you can create a submenu that has all the keyboard shortcuts from the application's menu structure. For instance, you can name the submenu File, then set each of the subsequent slices to the keyboard shortcuts most commonly used from under the File menu. You can see how just doing this can give you a visual, interactive alternative to your keyboard. If you invest a lot of time building a radial menu or configuring your Cintiq, be sure to back up your settings with the Tablet Preferences File utility. This is in Applications Wacom Tablet on a Mac or All Programs Wacom Tablet on a Windows system. Once you have the file utility open, just click Backup, choose a location for the backup file, and give it a name. Now, if for any reason you lose your settings, or you want to take your tablet to a new computer, once you have the driver installed, just use this file to restore your settings. This has been a brief introduction to the Cintiq 13 HD and its features. It's a small but powerful tool, both sleek and compact, yet loaded with time-saving features that are literally at your fingertips. Learn more about using and configuring the Express Keys in Rockering in the video Customizing the Cintiq 13 HD. Or check out our other videos at wacom.com or youtube.com/wacom.